Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to discuss another problem. Problem is domino and tromino tiling. So in this problem, we are given two types of tiles, 2 into 1, which is like this, and a tromino shape like this. So you may rotate these shapes. We can rotate this. So this tromino tile, we can make it upside down, or we can rotate it 90 degree or somewhat. Given an integer n, return the number of ways to tile and 2 cross n board. Since the answer may be very large, return it modulo 10 raised to 9 plus 7. So in a tiling, this is like a condition. So 2 cross n board will be given n, like n is 3. So the board will be 2 cross 3, which is 6. So if you see this example, where n is 3, this is 6. 2 cross 3 board, 2 cross 3. So let's see number of ways in which we can place these tiles, domino and tromino, are 5. Let's see how. So if you are given n is equal to 3, means you have 2 cross 3 board. So it will be something like this, 2 cross 3. So 2 cross 3. Now, how you can place all the tiles? One way is that, so see, we have two these tiles. These are 2 into these one tiles, 2 into 1 domino, and these one are tromino. So we have like this, these are tromino. So either what we can do is we can place all the dominoes like this. So it will cover. This is one way. Another way is that what we can do is we can place, let's see what's the other way over here. It's given. So one way is like this. Yeah, we can do it like this, that we place one like this and other two like this. So right now we are using only dominoes. So this is another way. And you can check other ways also, like how they have done. So they have used the tromino like this, that if we have tromino, what we can do is we can place it like this. So this will be our tromino. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 3 tiles covering. So I hope you understood it. So when n is 3, that means we have 2 cross 3 board. So the number of ways are 5. Now, if you Since see, whenever there are these type of questions, na, where you have to find number of ways, then what you need to do is you need to analyze two to three test cases. Like, if you take n is equal to 4, when n is equal to 4, then your board will be 2 cross 4 board, which means it will be like this, 8. If you make it 2 cross 4, 1, 2, 3, like this. So how many ways are there? Total there will be 11 ways of arranging different, like occupying all these tiles using dominoes and tromino's. So let's see some of the ways. Like, one you can do is you can place all the dominoes like this. This is one way. Or other way, what you can do is you can place all domino like this, covering two tiles. See, domino will cover two tiles, na? And this will be this one. This will be, here will be one domino. Here will be one domino. This is one another way. Or one more way is that what you can do is that you can place the these like this, and these like this. These are two dominoes, and one here will be domino. So these also can arrange in themselves. So these are some ways. When n is 4, your total ways will be 11. Right. And when n is equal to 1, let's start from the beginning. When n is 1, means your board will be 2 cross 1. That means 2 cross 1 is like this. 2 cross 1. So here you can place one domino. So there is only one way when n is 1. When n is 2, then the board will be 2 cross 2. So 4 means like this, your board will be. So here you can place one domino, here you can place one domino. Or what you can do is you can place one domino like this and one domino like this. So there are two ways when n is 2. So 2. So see, you have calculated for 4 test cases, for 4 n's you have calculated. Now we will see a pattern between these. We'll see a pattern. So let's start with this 5. See, for 5, you will see that it is like 2 into 2 plus 1. Right? So, and let's take n is equal to 0 also. If n is equal to 0, then it will be 0. 0, right? 2 into 0, it will be obviously 0. So, for this 2, it could be 2 into 1 plus 0, something like this. And for this 4, what it could be, or let's say, for these 0, 1, 2, na, when n is 0, 1, 2, we will be using these, like, same as this. N is, like, the values are same as n, na, so we can use them directly. There is no need to see a pattern here. Then over here, when it is 11, so you will see it will be 2 into 5 plus 1. 11 is 2 into 5 plus 1. Now, right now, what I can see a pattern is something like this, that 2 will be there. So over here, it was 5, which was answer of the previous n. Currently, n is 4. Let's say this is, 11 is a of n. A of n means a of 4. N is 4. So a of 4 is right now 11. And 5 is a of n minus 1. See, n is 4. N minus 1 will be 3. A of 3 is 5. So 2 into a of n minus 1. Over here also, see, it was 2, which was previous n's value. So, plus 1. As of now, we can conclude that this is a kind of relation we are getting. A of n is equal to 2 into a of n minus 1 plus 1. Now, but I think we should not make conclusions about this one. Because it could be a case where this value could be replaced by some other. There could be anything else also here. So for that, we will be calculating for n is equal to 5. And for that, the answer, it will be 2 into 5. And the answer which we will get for this will be 24 ways. So, if you see then, so it will be 2 into 11, which was the previous n's value, 11. Plus, here now it will come 2. So if you see, now this 2 is where? This 2 value is not 1. It's not 1. So we cannot conclude that here 1 will come. This 2 is here, which is n2. So currently we are at n is equal to 5. And this 2 value is at n is equal to 2. Means it is 3 less. So this here, it will come a of n minus 3. So if you see, this relation will be valid for this 11 also, 5 also, 2 also. So this is a relation using which we will be solving the problem. So if you see, for current n value, we require two values, n minus 1, n minus 3. So these two values only are required every time. So let's see the code now. I hope you understood the approach. Let's see the code. So I hope you understood the approach. Let's see the code. So in the code, we are taking MD value, which is the modulus value. Then we are making a vector, which will be storing our previous results. So we saw that for n is equal to 1, the value is 1. N is equal to 2, value is 2. And n is equal to 3, number of ways are 5. Right? So we are storing for 1, like we are populating these values. And if n is less than equal to 3, So we know that the answer will be the like 1, 2, 3. Over here you can write n also. So then we will be iterating. I will be starting from I is equal to 4. So we saw the relation. It will be 2 into vi minus 1. See, we saw that. So it will be 2 into n minus 1 plus n minus 3. So n minus 1 plus n minus 3. And we are taking a mod of this because this value could be very large. And then we are returning v of n. So I hope you understood the code. It's very simple. So it's getting accepted. So the time complexity for this is O of n, as we are doing single traversal. And the space complexity is also O of n because we are taking a visit. We are taking this array. Although we can avoid using this array if we store these values, previous values, we can use variables. But that also we can do. So I hope you like the video. If you found the video helpful, please like it, share with your friends, subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in the next video.